In this video, in the next slides, we are going to speak about a very interesting topic in strategic management, as is the family business. Okay, we are going to start by name two or three characteristics of family business here in Spain, but I think that with several differences, it will be applied worldwide. Well, first of all, here in Spain, between 65% and 70% of the total business in Spain are considered to be family owned. So we can say that they are a family business. Just with that figure, you can take in account that we are speaking about a huge reality that is not very often treated in strategic management, but we have to speak about what are the main values of such family business, and of course, what are the advantages and disadvantages of such model. Another interesting fact is that the contribution by these businesses to the Spanish gross national product, GNP, is around more or less 65%. And the family business employing about the 80% of the private workforce. So just with that couple of data, we can see that family business maybe are not the most productive ones, okay? Maybe multinational ones are more productive, but they have a huge part of the economy and they represent a very important part of the strategic management, and therefore we have to analyze them. The rotation in top management positions is significantly lower in family business than in no family business, for example, in multinationals or etc. So, therefore, on the next slides, we are going to speak about several values of the family business. Well, of course, it's going to depend on the family, it's going to depend on the family business, it's going to depend on each company, but we can say that there are five values that are usually present in all family business, okay? It's what we call in strategic management the ELISA values. The ELISA values are formed by words excellence, labor ethics, initiative, simplicity, and austerity. We are going to just name a couple of features of those values on the next slides. When we speak about excellence in family business, we mean that all family business show a constant striving for excellence in their products, services, brand name, organization, etc. Of course, it's going to depend on the company, but this is a general statement on excellence. When we speak about labor ethic, we say that work hard and with absolute dedication is one of the strengths on family business commitment. Of course, there could be exceptions. There are some companies, family business, in which there are no labor ethic, but the general rule is that there is a big commitment of family business with labor ethic. Another value of the ELISA values is initiative. Family business are characterized by having a big degree of initiative, but it's a problem with such degree of initiative which have to be assumed by financial risk, okay? By having a credit, a loan, or by assuming financial risk. The company that wants to be successful must be willing to change, and sometimes this implies assuming certain financial risk. As you know, this is a controversial point since family business have always been reluctant to about getting into debt. So let's say that the initiative is a strong value of the ELISA values in family business, but usually family business are reluctant about getting into debt. Another important value of the ELISA values of family business is simplicity. Simplicity usually exists in the private lives of the members of the family who own a successful family business. They usually don't behave in an ostentatious way. For example, of course, this is that does not mean that they are not very proud of the family business. Okay. And finally, the last value of the ELISA values of family business is austerity. It's a very important value. We can say, as we said when we spoke about the initiative, that family business are more prudent when taking on expenditure. So they are reluctant to having into debt, and they are prudent when taking on some expenditure. Their decision-making process in terms of investment is so much lower than in a normal company. And they carry out detailed studies of the project, since the money used on such spender is of the family. So it's not just about the board of directors or the general manager. And they are aware that they are going to spend the family's money, and therefore they carry out a detailed study before having any extraordinary expenditure. And here you can find a small video of the CEO of Sunworld Brothers, which is a family business, a quality food family business, and is a prominent member of the Institute of Family Business and Family Vision in the United Kingdom. Here in its webpage, you can find some values more or less matching with the ELISA values for family business, such as investing for the long term, promoting a strong and stable culture, personal commitment to the business and the customers, acting quickly without bureaucracy, taking risk without fearing the public price or failure, and having united, supportive shareholders. So we are gonna watch a small video of the CEO.
I'm Mark Somerth. I'm a fourth generation member of our family business, which has been going since 1896. We're a producer of premium chilled foods for the UK market, turning over about £800 million with 8,000 people. We've had the great benefit of having gone through not only good growth in the last 10-15 years, but also succession of management and of family ownership. Family businesses are important in the UK and globally because in the UK they're two-thirds of the number of private businesses. Family businesses are the engine of growth. We're the job creators. We are the oxygen that allows our economy to breathe. We're sometimes little understood. Happily now, there's more focus going behind it, and we as businesses need to stand up and make sure that government, that other sections of society really understand the good that we can do, not only in creating jobs, creating wealth, but as ambassadors and working people working closely in our community. And part of what we've done in the past has been to write a constitution that allows us to manage our expectations about how we're engaged with the business, for example. If we want to join the business, how many years do we have to do outside? What educational standards are expected? Who sets our remuneration and disciplinary policy? So yes, we have a constitution that the whole family has agreed to, and that's allowed us to operate as a family, knowing that all of the big decisions are already out there in the open. We work hard at retaining a family business culture. I, as a member of the family, go around all of our businesses, and I do workshops, cultural workshops, with our managers, directors, to ensure that people understand where the culture's come from, why we want it to grow and strengthen in the future, and the values we think that can add to our customers. We think in the chilled food industry in particular, family ownership can give that very rare thing, which is trust and long-term planning, when actually other models of ownership sometimes work against the consumer interest by being too short term. Well, one of the great things about a good family business is that the shareholders speak with one voice, if we get it right. And that means that the business can pursue a consistent strategy. And it can take the comings and goings in the short term, up and downs in the economy, in its stride. The ability to be independent of all other influences, I think, adds great value.
And this is the end of fifth class. Thank you, students. Please, if you have any doubt, don't hesitate to contact me. Please remember that you have to complete several quizzes of this class. They are very, very easy quizzes, just to check out that you have seen the videos. And you have to participate, please, in the discussion that we have uploaded today. And please don't forget that you have to submit the draft written case analysis by this Friday, okay? Just with a couple of guidelines of the draft of the written case analysis. So I do not need the written case analysis complete. I do not need the 1,500 words. I just need a couple of guidelines in which you tell me the two companies you have chosen, the industry you have chosen, and more or less the guidelines of the written case analysis. Thank you, students, and see you on next Friday.